Hello guys, how are you today? I hope you're fine. Before we start our lesson, I want you to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell for more videos to come. Today we're going to talk about viruses, the structure of viruses, the characteristics of viruses, and the mechanism of action. Okay, let's start with the structure of viruses. The viruses vary in their individual structure, but all viruses contain two structures. These are the nucleic acid, okay, the nucleic acid is the DNA or the RNA, and then we have a capsid, which is a protein coat. Can you see where is the protein coat here? This is the protein coat. Can you see it? This is called the capsid, a protein coat that gives a virus its shape, and it makes up 95% of the virus. Other structures could, so these are the very common in most viruses, the protein coat and the nucleic acid. Let's start now with the other two structures that a virus could have are envelopes. This is the envelope, okay, that consists of lipids and are found only in some viruses, and it's believed to come from the host cell. Okay, the tail here, this is the tail that infects viruses that infect bacteria have a tail. So viruses that infect bacteria have a tail. This is called a tail, okay, used for attachment, which is used, can you see how it's made for attachment? Okay, let's know the characteristics of viruses. Viruses can only be seen using an electron microscope. They are very tiny, of course, and they are non-living structures. They are infectious. They do not display most of the characteristics of living things. They do not fit into any of the six kingdoms. Once inside a cell, they reproduce. They need a host, so on its own they will not do anything, but they need a host, so they need a cell to work on it. Can be harmless, others kill the host, their host. So what is a host? A host is a living cell in which viruses reproduce. They are selective when it comes their host cell. One type of virus enters one type of cell like a lock and a key. So here we have when the virus enters one type of cell, it acts like a lock and a key. Viruses contain genetic instructions that take control of the cell. So they contain genetic instructions that control the cells. Let's go to the action. Before we go to the action of viruses, let's take a look at the shapes of viruses. Viruses can be three shapes: helical, that's rod shaped here, this is the first one; cubic or polyhedral, this is the second type of virus shape; and then we have a complex, this is a complex type. We have, it consists of capsid, nucleic acid, sheath, and tail fiber. The polyhedral has an envelope, and here we have the helical virus contains nucleic acid. So let's go finally to the action of viruses. So what happens when the virus enters our body? When the virus enters or encounters a cell, they take over the cell's machinery. A series of chemical reactions occur, which leads to the production of new viruses. These viruses burst out of the cell and invade others, and so on. So, when this happens, the first host cell will be killed and destroyed, and the next will be, and so on. Viruses cannot do anything without a cell. When it enters the cell, it changes the way the cell works. Viruses are not living things, as they don't show all the seven processes of life. Okay, I hope that you enjoyed today's lesson. And if you have any questions, please write them down. Thank you for listening, and please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell for more videos. And goodbye for now. Have a nice day. Bye.